responding to a commercial structure fire. Originally started in a Salvation Army warehouse. They have upped this call to a 5-alarm fire.
That's the thing about this job. One minute you could be on a smaller incident working with your crew, or the next day you could be on a major wildland fire where you have 500, 2,000 firefighters. You have to work side by side with them seamlessly, just like they're your own crew.
We were dispatched to an outside fire. When we turned the corner from headquarters, we could see the large flume up that we had. The first arriving engine company requested a second alarm. Upon my arrival, we requested a third and consequently a fourth and a fifth alarm assignment. First alarm assignment, you get 5 inches in the truck. Second alarm, 5 inches in the truck, and then it just keeps going from there.
The last time you had a fire like this?
I have to be honest, I've never been on a 5-alarm commercial fire like this in the Inland Empire.
Engine 101 has a hose line deployed and is actively fighting fire. Our assignment is to go and mitigate the fire that has spread from the outside of the building to the inside of the building. This is a big fire. Probably going to be here all night.
With a large structure fire, the massive ember cast increases the risk of spilling onto nearby roadways or jumping to nearby buildings.
The incident commander has ordered additional engines because this fire has been making some runs. So we want to make sure that we protect the community around here.
You can kind of see back here where it's probably their loading area. So you see a couple of big rigs with some container trucks. So a lot of heat, a lot of flames back here still.
We hear loud pops. We're seeing a vegetation fire creeping outside of the containment lines. It's hot and it's dry. It's definitely going to go big.
We are working on trying to suppress the smoke that keeps causing us problems because we ended up with a bunch of different wildland fires as well, spot fires throughout this area due to the casting from this fire itself.
But you look around, you see that there's a lot more work to be done. Hose lines have to be moved. Engines have to be repositioned. I have my partner Fernando by my side. We know we have to get the job done.
Between the dry brush and the high temps, CAL FIRE calls Paris 1 crew to help attack the fire. Firefighters will use a 50-foot hose to extinguish the flames.
Can you scoot me up a little bit, Ben? Ricky, we're moving forward.
Come on, we gotta catch them. Water!
Water!
As wildfires burn throughout the state, crews race to extinguish a 5-alarm fire in Paris.
Watch feet!
When spot fires erupt around them, Paris 1 joins crews from all over the county to contain them.
Nando, keep it in check.
You see how firefighters work. This is a totally team effort between the ground crews that are trying to mitigate this problem. We try to throw as much equipment at this as much as possible so we mitigate the problem as soon as we can.
Ricky, we're moving forward.
So not only was this one of the largest fires in Riverside County history, it took all the firemen that were assigned to this incident to get the incident under control.
You'll see a lot of ladder trucks pouring water into the building. Firefighters still spraying water into the building, at least for a couple more hours until they mitigate the issue here. But there's gonna be lots and lots of mop-up going on.
We're gonna put all these small smokes, all these heat piles, and everything else that can possibly start another fire on our green side. So we're gonna put it all out and make sure that's completely out.
It's a loss of donations, but people are safe. So that's really what counts.
In Riverside County, the newly trained hand crew prepares for their big trial by fire.
Gentlemen, oh shoot.
Everybody eat something this morning. You guys already have some water. You got some coffee, you have some coffee, but have some water. Chase it down with some water.
Today was our meet and greet with all the chiefs. All our PIOs were there to see us off. It doesn't get any better than that.
Guess we're going on a fire.
We are responding to a vegetation fire off the 15 heavy fuels, that's heavy brush, threat to structures.
This is going to be the first fire for this hand cruise.
The volcano fire ignites in the foothills of La Cresta. The hand crew faces a fast-moving and dangerous blaze.
Yes, yeah, so I need them to come to the Y on Joseph's Canyon and make a hard right. The hand crews, I need to find parking at the Y.
Every step.
Let's go.
Hey,
dude,
get up, fellas. Let's go.
Look them up, top, man.
We got to get up there and start cutting line as quick as we can.
Dude, let's move. Move it out.
We got to get this thing either slowed down or check it until others arrive. If we don't bring it, who's going to bring it?
On the steep terrain, the fire reaches 5 acres within minutes. Their goal? To keep it under 10.
Hey, keep your eyes over there just in case we get a spot fire, okay? Just make sure everybody's looking, all right? Hey!
All I want is a foot straight. 1 foot straight.
That way.
Hey, make sure that guy in that nozzle doesn't blow the back in our line, man. Hey, have him push out the other way.
So right now, we're gonna do a leapfrog method, but we got a hose laying back of us that's pushing burn material into green. Catastrophic for us, man. That little piece that was so indiscriminately drug across now is smoking. Now we've got a spot across the line.
We bumping up Gilmore?
Yo, yo, man.
Gotta stop, police. Look around.
4 foot cut, 2 foot straight. We'll come back in one.
There you go.
Watch what you're dragging.
Don't drag the black.
So right now, just to kind of give you an idea of what's going on, pretty much the fire's been knocked down. The crews will continue to cut line, keep on punching everything in until everything's done. 100% mop up on a fire like this. If you saw the helicopter, helicopters were supporting. We don't need a helicopter anymore. The HELTAC crew will go back to the base and wait for the next fire.
Hey, make sure that's cleaned up right there. Hey, stop. If you got a pull up, yeah, run yourself. There you go, good job.